And I want to do a review on Bruno Mars' latest album, 24 Karat Magic. This album came out probably in December 2016, towards the end of the year. I'm gonna tell you this. I thought Bruno Mars was good, had good songs, great performer. You know, solid dude in terms of musically. And as we all know, he's a chameleon, man. He can go into different eras of time in his music. So he can go back to the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s. And now we see that he's worked his way up to the 90s. And so this new album, 24 Karat Magic, may be one of the best albums, pop albums, I might even have to say R&B albums, that has come out in a long time. If you follow his career, he's been really huge. Uptown Funk was one of his hugest album track as far as songs, him and Mark Ronson. And it was funky. He took a real funky approach to that, like almost like a James Brown-ish. So, going into that, this album, 24 Karat Magic, he comes out with the first single, 24 Karat Magic, and it's reminds me of like a Zapp and Roger song, of course, because it has the talk box in it. The bass line, funky, like a Zapp and Roger song, Roger Troutman, rest in peace. Feel good, feels real good when you hear it. His verses are a throwback to like early 80s hip hop. Or even James Brown, like he's not even singing, he's just talking. And he has like background accompanying him. Call and response on the song, so it makes for a great performance live. He can do this song live, but it is really good. Has a bridge to it that which breaks down. It's real good. kind of a remind you of what's going on today, but this song overall, I mean, it'll wake you up in the morning. I wake up to the song sometimes in the morning. It's just that good. It makes you feel good. It makes you feel on top of the air every time you hear it. Can't get enough of it. Next track is called Chunky. That one has a Midwest feel, West Coast. Feels real good. But Chunky is about a female behind. Basically. And so I would say on this album, man, he's really straightforward with the women. I mean, 24 Karat, he's straightforward about who he is as a player, you know, as just a guy that's on top of the lot, top of life. He attributes it to God, but he letting you know, man, he is on top of the world. So Chunky, he's real aggressive. As in telling a chick, you know, telling you what kind of chick he likes, the type of girl he likes, what her figure is like, and how he loves a woman with a chunky behind. And it's a great song. It's good. And then, oh my gosh, the bridge on this. I'm going to tell you, throughout this whole album, he has bridges on here, every song. And a bridge is, oh my gosh, it just takes you back to when music was really, really, really good. So Pharrell, he taps into the same thing of bridges, but yeah, Bruno's killer with the bridges. So Chunky kind of have a Midwest feel. It is a great transition from 24 Karat Magic. Next track is called Perm. Perm, it's like a throwback to James Brown. The hook goes, put some perm on your attitude because you need to relax. So, oh my goodness, Perm is good. Lyrics are funny. He's like flirting with a girl on the song. Oh my God, the lyrics are good, man. He's flirting with a girl in the song, just like you know, trying to get a girl. Oh my God, it's good. It's good. Funky. Reminds you of like James Brown, real up tempo, you know, and live, just like a live band playing, kind of like a probably if it was an album on, if this was on like an album with Uptown Funk, it would fit right in. And it's kind of a throwback, but it's up tempo. Next you have Versace on the Floor. Versace on the Floor remind you of like it's very pop, but it reminds you of like go back to like early 90s, maybe even late 80s. If you think about like going to the skating ring, it's like a mid-tempo ballad, but the song, the lyrics, it's real central. Versace on the Floor, you just have to hear it. But it kind of reminds you of like I want to say Kid New Kids on the Block, but it made me think about New Kids on the Block when I heard it. But it's good, it's really good. And I think this might have been his first single he came out with prior to 24 Karat, that he leaked out there. When it goes to the bridge, it has the synth, it's a synthesizer hook, bridge. Oh my, synthesizer solo reminds you of like 80s, 90s, early 80s, late 80s, early 90s. Makes me think about like, oh my God, it's so good. Reminds me like a Devontae Swing when he plays his solos or something like that, man. Oh my goodness, this is so good. It takes you like to the sky. Really good. Next track, which to me is the when I heard this, I was like, this is the best song on the album, and this is gonna be a hit. It's gonna be everybody's favorite. I knew it, and now everybody is singing. Everybody I know that heard it song and loves the song sings it all the time. And it's called That's What I Like. This song has, oh my goodness, it's so good. It's just I played it like 50 million times. That's What I Like. And he's basically just talking about taking a girl out on a trip, taking her and all these things that you know that he wants to give her. You know, she's like all the things you like, I like too. All the things that you're doing. All the things that are happening in this situation, that's what he likes. And it's so good. He's like, I just want to show you a good time, girl. And what you do, that's what I like. But it's so good. Has like a like the trap drums and stuff on it. Like the trap breakdown on it. It's ridiculous. But it has like the synths, every element, a lot of elements that you kind of felt in 24 Karat Magic in terms of the synths used in it. It's really good, but oh my goodness, like it has a bounce to it. I can't describe it. You just have to hear the track. One of the best songs on there. That's what I like. And the bridge, oh my God, the bridge to this song is so infectious. Oh my God, this is a good song. This is probably his best song, man. Which make this, oh my God, makes it. I just can't stop talking about the song. It's so good. His best song, dude, like for real. That's what I like. It's his best song he's ever made. Anyway, stop gushing over the song. Next, Calling All the Lovelies. It sounds like a throwback to like some 80s, but it's really good and it's funny because he's basically talking about how he's calling a girl. He's waiting for her to pick up the phone, but she's not. So he's like, look, I got all these other chicks waiting. I'm not waiting for you. However, deep down inside, he really is feeling some type of way because she's not answering. And he really does want her to answer because he's really feeling her. So he's kind of being macho, but he's really fronting because he really does dig this chick. And what's funny about this whole album is he comes off as like this really confident, swagged out guy, but he wears his heart on his sleeve. He has all these feelings, so But he comes off as a confident dude. And I like that, man. I like the fact that he has a personality on this whole album. A lot of people, you know, some people I've seen in some reviews say, oh, man, it's kind of cheesy stuff he says. But it's like, yo, there's dudes who are really alpha males and really like, yo, be aggressive. But they still have a heart, you know. And so I can relate to all of that. I'm like, yo, this dude is really good. But calling all the lovelies is funny. He has a, it's a surprise on there. He's calling Holly Berry. So you could tell he's trying to throw back to like the 90s. Because she was the it girl back then. It's kind of funny. But so I gave the surprise away. Oops. Anyway, but it's a good, oh my God, the hook on this. I mean, the bridge on that is, it reminds you of like 60s or 70s songs. Pick up the phone, is all this loving. Need your heart. Oh my God. Oh my goodness, so good, man. And it breaks down. Oh my goodness, good song. Straight Up and Down. That song, I think, the next song, Straight Up and Down, I think T-Pain was involved with this song, and then one of the guys from Shy, the 90s group Shy, and this song kind of reminds you of a Shy song from the 90s. If you remember Shy, they had a song, If I Ever Fall in Love Again, and it reminds you of Baby I'm Yours, their song Baby I'm Yours. Straight Up and Down is good, and he's just talking about how beautiful she is, straight up and down, and you know. Oh, it's good. It's a good song. The bridge. Hook is good. The bridge. It's funny because this song, I think he's talking about a girl's booty in this one too. But the bridge to Straight Up and Down. Oh, it's good. Really good. Knocks out the park. Then Killer dance track, Finesse, reminds you of Teddy Riley. Really good. Crazy. Yeah, man. Reminds you of like, actually it's funny because it starts off like do 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 do. It reminds you of like BBD's Poison, but it takes you right back to New Jack Swing. Oh my God. Last track to close it out, Too Good to Say Goodbye, ballad, Babyface involved in this song, knocks it out the park, closes out the album. Overall, I'm going to say Bruno Mars, maybe the second coming, Michael Jackson. I'm going to end it right there. Get this album. If you ain't got it, get it. It's good. He's probably the second coming of Michael Jackson. Yeah, I said it. Peace.